Recently, when I was in Malaysia, I met some Muslims that were Uyghur, and they told me about the state of the Muslims in, you know, in that province of what is now claimed to be China, which isn't really China, and the state of those Muslims, the fact that they can't even go pray the way we, you know, there's military presence outside their masajid. So many masjids are being destroyed, like just destroyed. The fact that we even come, have the blessing of standing in the house of Allah and sitting and listening to a khutbah in the house of Allah, we take that for granted. There are people today, right now, in the world, who cannot go there unless they risk their life. There are people who, you know, if you find copies of Quran, if you find a tafsir of the Quran, then your family can disappear. Your family can disappear. This is the state of the Muslims. This is how they're living. There are places, they're, you know, in Ramadan, they force them. They have these beer drinking contests during the fast. And they force the men to drink beer publicly. And if they don't, their families will disappear. And they force this on the Muslims. This is the state of those Muslims. What's happening in so many places in the world doesn't even make it to the news. It won't make it to the news. And these catastrophes that are happening, at the very least, everybody says, we gotta do something, we gotta do something. And yes, we have to do something. And some people say, we have to go after the governments, or we have to be politically more active, we have to raise our voices. And I don't deny any of those concerns. And I don't deny any of the political activism, or the call for justice, or to hold, you know, corrupt government leaders to account. None of that. But you know, Allah says in the Quran, يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. They know what is outside in the worldly life. Everybody hears this and says, let's make dua for our brothers and sisters. Yes or no? Every time you hear something like that, we say, at least make dua for these people. At least make dua for the oppressed. At least make dua for the women and children. Those women and those children and those old men that are being thrown in jails, they're our fathers. They're our children. Our bond to them is La ilaha illallah, which is thicker than blood. That's thicker than blood. That's our family. That's not somebody else's daughter. That's my daughter. That's not somebody else's sister, that's my sister. Those are my parents. And that pain is supposed to be felt, and the very least we can do is make dua for them. So we say make dua for them. And around the world,